overseas, my Cali Bay life, how was Spain? We get into the money and you having issues. I bought a and it came with a wetsuit. The Buddha left me without breath. I really am a mess. I'm mooching off my mouth. She be hoping that I take a knee. Yes, I be open to that shrimp life. This is how we live, this is how we exist. Love the kicks and we love the hits. All in the house and I'm wrecking. If I sleep, I'm a wreck. I'm in my own world. Throw the money up and make my own weather. Mommy playing tether on leather. Money talk, it's a lecture. 80 pointers dance on me, it's electric. Don't hate, I'm still unaffected.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. With that, the wait is finally over. It is Super Bowl Sunday. For the call, here's our veteran duo of so many Super Bowls, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, we have played 266 games in this NFL season. Only one remains, and it's the biggest of them all, as EA Sports is proud to present coverage of the Super Bowl. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. Alongside my good friend Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. We are honored to be here for the biggest spectacle in sports, the Super Bowl. Are you ready, partner?
I am more than ready, and I love the word you used, honored, because it is an honor to be here. It's a privilege to be here. My excitement is just about to burst through the booth. I can't wait to do this.
Well, and sitting with both of these teams and talking in the meetings and media day and all the hoopla that goes into this, there was one common theme. They're ready to stop the talking and start playing football.
Yeah, they were probably ready a while ago. Now they can just focus on it. It's done. The only talking they have to worry about now is post-game, and they hope that they'll be talking as the winning team.
And we'll see. You know, both sides come in with a game plan to start. We'll see how the adjustments are made throughout, because there are always adjustments in this game.
I want to see if they come out conservative, trying to minimize errors, or if they have enough confidence to attack early and try and take advantage of the other team's nervousness.
Here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. Okay, there's a tone setter. First play from scrimmage, stuff him in the backfield.
You know what they were doing last night in the hotel room? Visualizing exactly that. That's what they were thinking about. Making that play, having leverage, lower than the offensive lineman, getting into the offensive backfield, knocking someone down. Just what you said, setting the tone early for this game.
Jeez, you are fired up.
When I see a play like that, I can't help it.
A gain of a yard gets them back where they started. Now it's third and 10. Take this one up to the 35-yard line. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for fourth down. On fourth down, here's Lachlan Edwards to punt it. This is fielded at the 7. Excellent work on the run back there, 33 yards, and the Bears take over. They'll start with a give to Cohen. He'll take this from the 40 up to the 45 for a gain of 5. Second down following the run. They try again with Cohen. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other, that control on the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense, because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on, and it's second down. Second and 10. Bates. Man open left side. It's Williams. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
On third down, Bates. McKenna here. It's complete. And he gets it to the 32, good enough for a first down. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And room there to work it inside the 25. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Operating from the gun, Bates. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
And New York set to take the field. And a 3-and-out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
They'll look to throw here on first down. To the sideline, and wow, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot, but he was able to get the feet down complete. Give him a couple on the catch at 2nd and 8. Second down now after the pass completion.
Let's go! Ryan 38!
They'll run it now out of the gun. Despite the good footwork, he'll be hit and dropped shy of the 45. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5.
I once had a defensive player in the NFL tell me, if I beat and dominate the guy across from me, I'm helping my team. Well, winning one-on-one battles is always a part of the game. But when you have good team defense, as we just saw there, one broken tackle, but he didn't get away because the rest of the guys arrived to put him on the ground.
Found his target. It's Anderson. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
So they jumped on the left side of that line.
And you know, when you're at the end spot, you are like in the starting blocks, waiting for the pistol to fire and go, and he jumped a little bit too early.
Now a play fake here on first down. And Gurley here fumbled it. Gurley fumbles the football. It's loose. And this is picked up by the Bears. 20, 10, and they bring this one back. A fumble return for a Bears touchdown. And on the grandest of stages, with a whole world watching the Super Bowl, they come out and get the first points.
I don't know how you feel about Brandon, but for me, watching the beginning of the Super Bowl, I've often wondered how come it's not just a fumble fest. How come the ball's not all over the place? The nerves, the interim in between of the 2 weeks waiting for the game. But this team came out and handled it just like it was a regular season walk in the park. Terrific start.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. This is Bell on the dump off. So one quarter down here in the Super Bowl. It's a close game here early on. You are watching the NFL on E! With Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden with you. It's the Jets in possession as we begin quarter number two here. They've got it second and four to start things out. Give to Bell. Oh, and now he bowls him over. Le'Veon Bell, kiss him goodbye. And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line. It's a big run that time by Bell. 46 yards. And for those worried about whether or not Le'Veon's explosiveness would return, I think we just had our answer.
ACL. What ACL? This guy's back running as if he were totally healthy and never had had an issue.
And they'll keep it on the ground with Bell. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second in just about a few inches here.
Not an ideal spot to be on first down, but I love that the play caller did not immediately abandon the running game and say, okay, we've got to throw it in order to pick it up. Stayed with the run, was rewarded with a big-time pickup. Now they're in second and manageable.
Here we go! Black round!
He'll look to throw. And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. Take care of him. In there to bury him for a loss of 11.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, that allows your blitzers to get there.
Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
And Elliott puts this one through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So this offensive unit, they've now had three drives, and they only have 3 points to show for it.
Payoff is the key for everything. How many offenses have we talked to that say we have to finish drives? Thus far, this team hasn't finished it quite the way they wanted to.
There he is, the man taking the snaps under center, heading out for the next possession. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. But let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense. Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole that closed there quickly at the end. They'll run it now out of the gun. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
That was a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Here we go. Throwing on first down. Bates. He's got a man open. It's Cameron Meredith. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs.
Here we go now. Green 39. Green 39.
On first down, Bates. Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more.
And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. A great play there. 26 yards, and the Bears will add on to their lead. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover, and you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. Santos out now. He'll kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. And we put our focus now on Le'Veon Bell. Now, he's having himself a little bit of a banner game. His team right now, though, losing.
Needs a little bit of help, and I kind of equate it to a basketball game where you have the big score, and sometimes your strategy is, okay, he can go ahead and have all of his points. Let's hold down everyone else, and that's the way you win the game. And right now, he needs everyone else to start scoring, quote-unquote, as he's been.
Yeah, and he's hoping to keep it close so maybe they can keep it on the ground, not start to go through the air as much. A minute 59 to go in the first half. We'll come back on Super Bowl Sunday after this. A reminder, coming up at the intermission, we'll get highlights of this Super Bowl from Larry Ridley and the crew in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Back to throw. And his throw here is incomplete. Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver. And it's second down.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
Here we go.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
feels like they're getting caught in between here, because any completions on first and second down, now you got to worry a little bit about the clock, because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
The Jets on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 10.
Let's go! Run 38!
They're going to look to throw. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. A good pickup there, 22.
I know you're trying to have a scoreboard watch, but you only got 3 points. You're kind of hoping that that type of play there gives you some positive momentum going into the half.
Yeah, I need to do something to get more than that 3 number that they have on the scoreboard right now.
Let's go! Grand 38!
They'll set up a throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. And it's a rush to the line right now for the Jets. The shotgun, he'll look to throw. It goes as a loss of 6. And now 3rd down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also 3rd down.
There we go.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to look deep for Perriman. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. Picked off here by Jimmy Smith. And he will take this all the way down to the 38-yard line.
So it's 3rd and long, and you know this is going to be a pass. So defensively, they're bringing an extra defensive back and just blanking the field. And this is an ill-advised throw right here as it winds up being picked off easily.
All right, here we go. Blue landing.
On 1st and 10, Bates. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Looking to throw on 2nd down. Bates, and he rips that one incomplete there.
But he kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
And on 3rd down, a nickel formation here defensively. From the gun, Bates. Over the middle, complete. It's Cullen. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. Oh, he's got a little daylight. Nice stiff arm.
Underused, but still effective.
And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. 1st down and 10 now for the offensive group. He'll look to throw. He'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. Now the Jets going to use the 2nd of their 3 timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half.
Come on, let's go!
Back to throw now on 1st down. Caught here by Bell. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. And it's a rush to the line right now for the Jets. Now a shotgun snap as they look to throw.
And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. It's a four-yard pickup, and that's going to bring up a third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
The Jets on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third down and 12. They'll look to throw here. Left side complete, Safarian Jenkins. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th. Well, this is how you shape the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4 for 4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when who told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row. I'm going to stay confident, keep flinging it. I just figured there's something wrong with the football.
So we've come upon halftime in the big one, the Super Bowl. As we send you on down to our studios in Orlando, where standing by is Larry Ridley with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime.
I know when I joke about you guys skipping halftime, sometimes you get frustrated, but this is the Super Bowl. You got to watch the halftime show of the Super Bowl. All right, let's get you to the third quarter. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. So here's the Bears' offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They built a good first-half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. A big play there on the catch and run. 49 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield, but when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Leonard Williams in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. And they weren't in zone coverage. They were in man, and each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old-school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a Defensive Player of the Year at the other, and they just locked people down.
A good pickup there of 20 yards.
Well, for teams that like to play man coverage, running corner routes can be tough on them because of the ability of getting into it. Sometimes you're squaring it off. Sometimes you're just rounding it. Sometimes there's a fake. Sometimes there's not. That makes it very, very difficult for a DB to stay with it.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to get it inside the 10 to the 7-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
To throw on 2nd down. Bates, the quick slant caught, and he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. A 5-yard gain, and now they're set up 1st and goal.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a 1st down.
And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the 3. That's going to go as a loss of 1 yard, and it'll be 2nd down.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert?
Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Cameron Meredith from 3 yards out. And the Bears will extend their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit, get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, second half, no matter what, whether it's first 5 minutes, first three, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here's the Jets offense now as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. On second down, it's Bell. And he'll get about three here as he's out to the 30.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
On third down, here's Bell. Bell sheds it. Le'Veon Bell, it's a foot race. 30, the 20, and all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Le'Veon Bell, 70 yards. And the Jets are able to close the gap just a bit. That's a score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
Elliott now to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. They begin the drive on the ground with Cohen. They find some open field here, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Hey, I'm watching that body, body! Watching that body, body! Here we go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. Give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them.
Here we go.
Throwing on first down. Bates looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Blair. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. The completion good for three, and it's second down. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him, and what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches. Just keep mixing it up, give him different angles, different looks, like a good boxer does.
Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
To throw on third down, Bates. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep down his...
Back now here on EA Sports. It's Bears football here. They also have the lead as well as we begin quarter number 4. And this one is right down Broadway. And that will get the lead up to 14. So he splits the uprights there, and I would imagine it's nice as a kicker. Right when it leaves your foot, you know it's good.
Yeah, it's kind of like a golfer that picks up his tee after a nice drive without even watching it land.
Solid analogy. I like it. That'll be taken in the end zone, and he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Now the Jets offense about set to take over as they head onto the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Jet first down. At this stage, this drive's got to be touchdown or bust because you need two of them.
And if I'm the offensive play caller, I'm not just looking at my dagger plays downfield. I'm looking at some of my specials, something that can fool them and give you a big play now.
With a sense of urgency.
No doubt.
A gain of 6 there on first. Fourth quarter, every drive's so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second one to even matter.
That's complete over the middle to Anderson. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
They'll set up to throw. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. Throw, and that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
And we just saw another example. These cornerbacks have played tight coverage all game long. Might start wanting to think about a few double, triple move routes to try and shake their guys free.
Because they have, you're right, they have had no room to breathe. The offense on third down tonight, 3 for 7 so far in this game. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. He'll drop to throw, and he finds Safarian Jenkins. And he gets it to the 32, good enough for a first down. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving. And a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified, big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get the third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
That is caught. At the 7. And he is out of bounds, but not before taking this inside the 10 to the 7. A good pickup there, 26 yards. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
3 yards is the gain that time, second and goal.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
The 4, it's second and goal. Now Bell fighting his way in for a Jets touchdown. Le'Veon Bell, his second touchdown.
Super Bowl. And the Jets are able to make this a close game again. He's having a nice little game. Maybe already has an eye on that third touchdown.
And how about what our producer, Christian McLeod, likes to say when they've scored touchdowns like this? He's put a tent up in Touchdown City.
Elliott now to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it? Touchdowns.
So they're leading. They have possession of the football, and certainly this is where they just want to milk the clock.
All right, here we go. Boom, 90! Boom, 90!
Now they try the right side here. And at a 42-yard line here and brought down there. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old-school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. On first down, Bates. And this will be caught, Tyrell Williams. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. See what the offense comes with here. Second and 8. Now a handoff looking right. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. The Bears on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 10. Operating from the gun, Bates. Looking for his tight end on the corner, it's complete. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. So the offense has it first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to be brought down at about the 33-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
Let's go.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And not much running room. Down to the 32. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. Doesn't matter whether you watch high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
That is likely the final play of this game, and no better feeling, I would imagine, than taking a knee to wrap up the Super Bowl.
Culminates everything. The championship is theirs. And just think, the last play they had in practice before this game began was doing this, practicing taking a knee and winning a Super Bowl.
And they get to do just that. And the Chicago Bears have etched their name in NFL history. They are your Super Bowl champions.
for the victors getting to hoist that Lombardi trophy. You know, we've talked to guys that have done it, and they say there's no better feeling in sports.
I don't know how there can be. The journey to get to this game is incredible. And then to finally break through and win it when all eyes are on this game alone because there's nothing else going on, that's just got to be absolutely amazing. That, the task, incredible. But the accomplishment, forever.
And they are the Super Bowl champs. A Lombardi trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.
Today.